Hi guys, my name is Molly Jean, for those of you that don't know me. Thank you guys all for coming out and listening to all of our stories about our mentorships. You guys have done some wonderful things. The Reagan program as a whole is doing some excellent things. So for my mentorship, I was out in Boston, Massachusetts, working for a company called Doe, and I'll talk a little bit more about what they are, what I did in a little bit. But I think it's kind of important to talk about the how. How did I get this? What even is this? So a lot of the questions that we all start with when we come to college is, what am I even going to do with my life? If you've known me since freshman year, you'll know that I've changed from education to art to business to arts administration to business and art to accounting and business to now accounting, business, and art. So it's been a long journey for me. But a lot of the things that I struggled with was that I love art. I think that being creative is very important in my life, but I need to be practical. How can I market myself? So I tried to find a way to combine that with business, and I started to think about doing things with fashion, which is quite funny because if you'll see me on a daily basis, I'm wearing most likely leggings and a sweatshirt that I have most likely stolen from my boyfriend. But the person I have to thank for the how, honestly, is the one and only Mr. Mike Murtaugh. He actually came into admissions and had asked me what I was doing for my mentorship, and I said, you know, I think I'm gonna possibly look into the fashion business. So he starts putting me into contact with one of our, personally, I think, the best alum that Eureka College has, right after Ronald Reagan, of course, who started the fashion project while she was a junior at Harvard Law School. She then went on to sell that project for $14 million and is a very, very amazingly successful woman. So this leads me to Super Bowl Sunday. So I start contacting her. She is a crazy busy woman. Sometimes she has thousands of emails, hundreds of texts. So getting in contact with her was slightly difficult. She called me while she was walking through the crazy spaghetti-like streets of Boston on her way to a Super Bowl Sunday party. And I originally thought that she was going to be a contact that was going to refer me to someone who would refer me to someone who would refer me to someone, and eventually, like noon, I would get on a plane and go somewhere. However, she gets halfway through the conversation and says, you know, this might come off as selfish, but I'd really like you to come and work with me this summer. I was like, okay, well, this is going to be a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. So she actually starts setting up things with me, and I didn't hear from her for about a week, again, falling into the crazy business world. However, she calls me up on a Tuesday and says, hi, I'm flying out to Peoria on Friday. Would you like to meet me? I said, okay, absolutely. She goes, I figure since you're moving halfway across the country to live in another city and work for someone you've never met, you might want to meet me. We closed down One World night. We talked 30 minutes past when they closed. The people there are wonderful and they let us just hang out. And that one conversation, I knew that I had met my lifelong mentor. And as one of the most beautiful, giving, caring people I've ever met. And then we go through the whole waiting period of I'm so excited to get out there. And 1 week before, she changes what I'm doing completely. Originally, I was supposed to be working for a company called Wonder Mile, which is focused on getting people back into brick and mortar stores. Because if you guys don't know yet, brick and mortar stores are slowly dying due to online shopping. This company fell through due to her colleague deciding that he hated the consumer world, so he wanted to get out of that. So she started her love project, Doe. This is my favorite thing ever. Out of all my jobs I've ever had, this is my favorite. It is a female-owned marketplace. When I got there, originally we were going to be selling a half dozen different products each week from different female-owned, female-led companies. This has now evolved into being a women-owned marketplace. We're trying to get all sorts of women-owned businesses, women-led businesses, because there's a lot of stats against women in business. And as somebody who wants to eventually start a business, that was pretty disheartening. My title, I actually got a title. I felt really, really official when I got this. I got to put it at the bottom of my signature on my emails. I am the Doe Outreach Coordinator. This means that I get to talk to all of you, all of potential customers. I get to make contacts with people, and I love it. I love talking to people in general, so it was a pretty great job for me. This turned into me making a lot of spreadsheets, sending a lot of emails. On the daily, I would probably send anywhere between 200 to 500 emails I was reaching out to people for shirt sizes, addresses. Would you like to know more about this? Would you like to be a partner one day? So the Boston work hours are the best, let me tell you. I don't know about you guys, but I fail at 8 a.m., so I'm not great at them. I don't like waking up early. I didn't have to be at work until 10, but that often turned into working very late nights. There were nights we didn't leave until 7. You'll notice there's a question mark next to 7. Some nights we didn't leave until 10. It just kind of depended. But these are the stats that I was talking about. So on average, women start companies with half the capital as men do. Men on average start with 6 times the amount of resources. In addition, only 4.8% of Fortune 500 companies last year had female CEOs. So us women are kind of struggling. Doe is trying to help us though, which is very exciting. This is Boston, which, as I previously said, this is where I was for a month. I have absolutely fallen in love with the city, and I am very excited to graduate because I plan on moving out there, actually. I took this picture when we went on a duck ride, which if you haven't been on a duck yet, you definitely should do that. It was a lot of fun. And it just, there's constant beauty in the city. There's so much history, and I was finding things every single day that I fell in love with. My job would be one of the many things I fell in love with, and these beautiful ladies in this picture with me. These were my daily coworkers. Some of them worked 3 days a week, some of them worked just 1 day a week, because a lot of us are working other jobs while we're trying to get Doe up and running as a company. But this picture is actually from the Monday right before I left. They took us out to Candlepin Bowling as a thank you for being there. I went with, if you guys will see the girl with the girl power written on her shirt, is Meredith Rhodes, if you guys don't know her. I had the pleasure of spending a month in Boston with her working side by side. The coolest part about being interns together is that not once were we those, hey, go get me a coffee interns. We had actual jobs. So like I said, I was the outreach coordinator that required a lot of calls, a lot of emails, things along those lines. And then when I get back, because I did get hired on, I do work for them part-time right now, full-time when I'm not in school. I was commenting, following, and helping grow our Instagram page, which is up to about 2,000 followers. Shameless plug, follow Join Girl on Instagram. But now I'm working on research, so I will also do a shameless plug here. If you guys know of any female-owned businesses, please send them my way. I am researching our potential partners in the future, which is very exciting. While I was out in Boston, the best part about it, not being treated like an intern, I also got to weigh in on things. So when you look at our logo, I voted on that. I was one of 10 votes on that. When you look at the pictures that we took, I was part of the photo shoot for that. Meredith directed it and I helped with setting things up. But I learned so much. This was an amazing month. I couldn't have summarized this in this slideshow, honestly. So if you guys have any further questions after my presentation, feel free to reach out. But Instagram has a lot more to it than you realize. We are currently shadow banned, which you probably, I have no idea what that even meant. So there's a lot of logistics that go behind things, even such as social media. There's always someone behind the scenes doing work. This leads into another point about startups. In the startup world, liberal arts education is excellent. Because the best thing about a liberal arts education is that we learn how to think on our feet and think in things that we're not good at. I got thrown into being an outreach coordinator and thrown into an Instagram. If you look at my Instagram right now, I have like 500 followers and I've had it for like 7 years. I don't know. So you learn a lot of new things. The startup world, you're constantly doing something new. I learned internet searching skills can do a lot of good in the startup world. Facebook stalking ends up being very productive when you need to get a hold of someone. I learned whatever I can do, it cannot be boring. Our thank you dinner with Anna, we actually went to the Boston Burger Company, which was my favorite place to eat in Boston. And this sign was actually in the back when I was walking to leave. And I thought it just really summed up the whole experience for me. That I don't know where I'm going yet, but I can promise you it won't be boring. I can't sit at a desk. Even though I'm an accounting major, I can't be an accountant. It's just not gonna work for me. But then I also learned the slightly more boring things, like a business process map. But like I said, the startup world is crazy and I'm excited to be part of it. What I learned part two. So you have the logistics, the smart things you learned. And then you have the things that you learned about yourself. Number one, no matter where I end up, no matter if I move to Boston or Seattle or all these other crazy dreams in my mind, it is important to know where I started from. I am a small town girl and I always will be. Anna is from Pekin. She has hopes and dreams of helping Pekin with their many issues that they currently have. She wants to give back to her communities. She's giving back to Eureka right now by being a mentor for me. So there's a lot of things like that. One thing that she taught me as well is try one thing every year that is out of your comfort zone because it makes you more interesting. This can be falconry is her next thing on her list. I'm trying glass blowing. So maybe smaller picture for me. Always have at least three fun facts about yourself on hand. You know those awkward icebreakers we have in class? Those happen at work too sometimes. And I was always like, oh, I don't know what to say. If someone says you can't do it, prove them wrong and do it better than they ever expected. That just is pretty self-explanatory. Number five, baptism by fire. If you don't, I learned that the best way for me to learn is to throw myself into things and just learn it by throwing myself in. That's not for everyone, but it worked really well for me. And then another thing is you can't always live off Starbucks refreshers. However, sometimes when you've been working till 7 or 8 or 9 at night, they can give you life. My pictures did not go through, except for there is the fireworks on 4th of July. I was blessed enough to be out in Boston. It was beautiful. Seriously, if you ever have a chance, go out there for 4th of July. It was breathtaking. That is coming into Boston. That is in front of the old State House, and then the one on the right, we actually got to take a weekend and go to Salem, Massachusetts. We went on a candlelit ghost tour, which that's us really pumped for the ghost tour before they literally scared us so much. But for my final thoughts, it was a great opportunity. Our alumni are amazing. I learned that our alums didn't even appreciate their Eureka College education as much as they do until they graduate. Because it's such a family. Once you have that Eureka College education, it makes you different, it sets you apart. So reach out to our alumni. They're great contacts, great resources. Any questions, feel free to email me at my school email, Albrecht16 at Eureka. But thank you to Anna Palmer, my amazing mentor, for always believing me and supporting me. She's actually offered to invest in my company in the next few years, so be on the lookout for that. Dr. T and Cherry for being amazing and always supporting all of us in our crazy endeavors. Meredith Rhodes for being my buddy for a month. We got to do so much fun stuff. Mr. Murtaugh for helping put me in contact. My parents, my amazing coworkers at Doe, they're the most inspiring ladies I've ever met. And then WeWork, which is the place that we actually worked at. And then my super sweet little old landlady, Anne. She was the nicest lady ever. And she always made sure that we had food in our bellies and that we were safe. So that is my presentation.